Yes, everyone. Very warm welcome to the class. Come on, everybody. So this is going to be a very important lecture today. Yes, yes, everyone. Oh, yes. Fine. Yes, Meena. This is absolutely no helpful for your MSc. Absolutely, it will be helpful for your MSc. Yes, yes. Everyone, welcome to the class. Oh, yes, Arpita, Perumal. Yes, yes. All right, come on. Ya Umarani, Neelima. Oh, nice, Neelima. Welcome to the class. Meena, Nisha, Chanda. Yes, Meena. This will be helpful to you. Yes, Rakesh. Very good evening, one and all. Come on. So, let us start a very important topic today. Yes, it is going to be on the type of species. All right. So, what is a species? So, this concept is coming under your ecology. Right? What is a species? Come on. Species, right? I am Dr. Saranya. Alright. So your species, it is a group of individuals, right, that are actually interbreeding in nature. Right? Fine. Yes. That is what is called as your species. So a group of individuals that are interbreeding, that is what is called as your particular species. Alright. Fine. So you have your genus and the species. So only if the species level similarity it is there, then only there is going to be your interbreeding. We could have seen this also in your sea urchin fertilization. What happens? Do you remember? I think very long back we saw. In sea urchin fertilization also, there will be a species specific breeding. Right. If some other species is coming, then the breeding will never take place. Okay. Because only the species will interbreed. All right, fine. So these are all the list of key species that we are going to see today, right? So what are these? Number one, your, yes, yes, Rakesh, keystone species, umbrella species, flagship species, indicator species, dominant species, and invasive species. So these are all very frequently asked up, in your examination. So let us take up each and everything with particular example. And after this, we will just look on certain hypotheses, right? So these hypotheses are dependent on your biodiversity and the type of species. It is called as your revert hypothesis. And then you do have your redundancy hypothesis. And then you have your idiosyncratic hypothesis. All right. And then your linear hypothesis. So even this we are going to discuss today. All right. Fine. So let us see in detail about all these important topics. Definitely 4 marks is there from this subtopic. All right. So let us see what is this keystone species. Right. So if at all you have seen this construction thing, right, the different stones are used for your construction. All right. Fine. But you can see that one stone in the arch. Yes. One stone in the arch, it is making up a very significant contribution to balance your arch, right? So if you remove this stone, what will happen? If you are going to remove this arch, what is literally going to happen? If you remove this this stone, what is happening? Your total arch is going to collapse, right? See, there are almost 20 stones, right? But if you remove this one stone, this is going to be very, very low in abundance. It is not more, only one stone. The abundance is going to be low, but the importance is very, very high. Got the point? All right, fine. So that is what is called as your keystone species, right? So these species are present in the low abundance, but the importance is seriously very, very high. So if you remove this species, your ecosystem is going to collapse. Right. So what are the common example of your keystone species? Yes. In general, your prey-predator relationship. Yes. So you remember a tiger. Right. So if there is no tiger, what will happen? Yes, if there is going to be no tiger, then literally what is going to happen of? there will be increase in the amount of deer. Yes, yes, oh nice. Yes, everyone, I didn't refresh, I guess. That's why I was not able to read your comments. Right, come on, Dr. Arun. Yes, Meena, Mayank, Rani. Yes, Rahul, Achu. Yes, Nitesh. Yes, everyone, very good evening. Right, right. Yes, Sadasiv, Pushpanjali. Yes, Neema, Neelima. Yes, yes. Absolutely. Right, right. Yes. Yeah, yes, Lavina. So, your tiger is going to come under your umbrella also, and it is going to come under your keystone also. Why? Because if you remove the tiger, what is happening? Your deer population is going to increase. Right. Yes, Akhilesh. So, if your deer is increasing, it will eat all the herbs. Right? Fine. So, there will be no grassland. If there is no grassland, who will die? All the deer will die. Isn't it? So if you remove the tiger, your total system is affected. Right. Absolutely. Oh yes, yes, Madhuri. Thank you. Right. Absolutely. So all the total ecosystem balance is going to get lost. Right. So that is why it is called as your keystone species. Alright. Fine. So the best example, you see this sea otter. Yes. Very happily lying on the sea bed. Right. The sea otter, if this is not there, see, the sea otter is absent now. Yes. Now what is happening? The sea urchin, yes, Rankis. So this sea urchin is feeding voraciously on the kelp. So see, there is no kelp now. Right. Yeah, the sea otters, they are good examples of your keystone species. Right. So if there is going to be no sea otters, the sea urchin population is going to reach high. If the sea urchin is very high, then there is no kelp. Got it? So if you remove the sea otter, the total ecosystem is destroyed. Alright. Likewise, you see this American alligator. What this American alligator does? Huh? It makes something called as the greater hole. What is that greater hole? It is going to dig something, right? It is going to dig and it is making a big hole. So in this hole, water can just go and fill the area. Yes, absolutely. So water is filling the area, right? So this water filled region, yes, even though the total river is empty, at least this sharp pit will attract many other organisms to stay inside. Yes, it is giving a place for your fish. Apart from the fish, the wading birds will come to eat the fish. Yes? Yeah, thank you, Rakesh. So, all other animals are... it is generally coming off to eat everything. Yes. So, that is how your American alligator is starting the chain of network. Right. So, now, if you are removing this American alligator, what is going to happen? Yes, absolutely. Yes, everyone. So, if you are removing your American alligator, your total system is going to imbalance. Right. So, if your total system is imbalanced, then your ecosystem is totally crushed. Right. Yes. So, this is also another example of your, this thing. Apart from that, you have your bees. Right. So, bees, they are meant for your pollination. If you remove the bees, there is no pollination. Right. Fine. Yeah, Srivastha. And all your large mammalian predators, tigers, they of course maintain the balance. Yes. Yeah. Yeah, Umarani. And then your sea stars, they are feeding on the mussels. Right. So they are also a good example. Hummingbirds, they are also serving as a good pollinator. Your African elephants, they are large mammals, I told you. Yes. So even it is helping off. Flying bat, fox bat. So all them are the example of your keystone species. Right. So what are the key terms for the keystone species? They are going to be low in abundance. Right. They are very low in numbers, but they are very, very important for the ecosystem. The number may be less, but they are very important for your ecosystem. So that is going to be your keystone species. So if you remove them, the total ecosystem is crashing. Alright. Next important example, it is an indicator species. Absolutely. What do you mean by this indicator species? See, it is going to reflect. What it is reflecting? It is going to reflect your environmental condition. Yes, this it is telling you about the health of your environment, right? So if at all the river otter is present, it is an indication that your water is clean. If your water is polluted, yeah, there won't be any other river otter in your river, right? Fine. And amphibian, my God, they are very sensitive. Why this amphibian is very sensitive? Yes, because their skin is very, very thin, right? So what happens because of this thin skin? See, because of this extremely thin skin, the chemicals can very easily go inside. Poor frog, what happened to this frog? It is showing a deformity. Why there is a deformity? Because the UV radiation has reached up and it is, has led to the deformity, right? Fine. So this is an indication that your environment is not clean. That is why this is a very good example of your indicator species. Got it? Yes? It is all leading to the mutation and it is an indicator species. Right. Next, lichens. Yeah. So this lichen, they are also a good indicators. In what way the lichens are indicator? The lichen will grow only in the pollution free area. That means it grows only in the, yes Nagvini. So it is growing only in the non-polluted area. Alright, so in the polluted area, the lichens, they not grow. Absolutely, because they are so much sensitive to your SO2. So they do not grow in the, yes, in the polluted area, absolutely. So that is why even that is a good indicator species. Likewise, your tubifex worms, I think I am hiding you, right? The tubifex worms, they grow only in the polluted area, right? So if at all your tubifex worm is present, you will know that that area is going to be highly polluted. Likewise, this hogloos, even they are growing in the mediumly polluted area. In slightly polluted area, you will find the freshwater shrimp. Yes, if at all your pollution is very, very low, yes, absolutely. Yes, Umarani. Yes, yeah, yes. So, yes, so both are indicators. Yes, because they are able to survive in the particular area, or certain species are dying in the particular area, you can find out the health of your environment. Isn't it? That is why all of them are indicator species. So if a lichen is not growing in a particular area, what do we infer? The area is highly polluted, right? So if a lichen is growing in the area, what do you infer? You infer that this is going to be polluted free. Yes, it is free of pollution. So it is going to serve as, yeah, is it? Right, it is serving as an indicator. Yeah, so these are all the indicator species. Alright, we are running short of time. Yes, yes. So we will go to the third type of organism. It is called as your flagship. What do you mean by a flag? Yes, absolutely. So flag, it is a symbol or it is serving as a brand ambassador. So the moment I project about this panda, yes. So what you get about this cute little panda? Yes, you remember your World Wildlife Fund? Yes, right, World Wide Fund, you remember that? Yes, yes, absolutely, yeah, yes. So lichen's absence is indicating a high level of pollution, absolutely, because SO2 is not going to allow your lichens to grow. All right, so yes, and you know, if you take this panda, it is, has become a symbol, right? So when you see this this symbol, you remember An Academy, isn't it? So certain symbols are there with which you can associate something, right? Fine, like that, when you see the panda, you just remember them, right? Whales and then dolphin, these are all the endangered species. But the moment you see the species, you become alerted that you have to preserve them. Yes, so what is a flagship species? It is a symbol or it is an ambassador for the total group. All right. Yes. So if you take your tiger, even your tiger is an example of your flagship species. Yes, you want to conserve and preserve the tiger. Yes, and then your giant panda, and then this golden lion tamarin. So cute fellow, golden lion tamarin. Your African elephant, Asian elephant, all of them are coming under your ambassadors. Yes, all right, fine. The next species, it is called as, yes, Sundarbans, absolutely. So the next species is called as your Umbrella species. What do you mean by an Umbrella species? So it is needing all such sophistication. If that species can survive, definitely all others will be able to survive. Yes, so there will be a person in every family, right? So they want every sophistication. So if that person is satisfied, it is understood that all others will live happily in that place. Am I right? Yes or no? Same thing with your organisms. Certain organisms, they need a large habitat need. Yes, it wants an air conditioner, it wants a heater, it wants everything such that it will survive. Right? For instance, I am telling you. Likewise, yeah, it is because of that much need, if that need is, it is considered and it is met, it is obvious that all others are happily surviving. Right? So that is what is called as your Umbrella species. Yes. So this is your bear, right? So this grizzly bears, they are good examples of this thing. Yeah, they are giving protection in the terms that it is allowing them to survive, because all these things, they require a large habitat. All right. Yes, that is the actual actual context. They are referring as an Umbrella species. See that you can get the total meaning by this one. Generally, you can classify your generalist species and specialist species. Okay? Yes, absolutely. Yeah. So, your Umbrella species, it is something like, they need a very large requirement. See this blue line? Yes? So, this blue line, it is seriously a very large requirement for your Umbrella species. If this blue line is met, yeah? Oh yes, Krishna, definitely. All these things, it will be very easily surviving on. Got it? Yes. So that is why this is called as your Umbrella species, and these are all, it is called as your target species. They have very requirement, very small requirement. But your Umbrella species is requiring this much big requirement, so it is going to meet it of that. Right. So the examples, it includes your manage, yes, and then your bay check spot butterflies, and then the owl. Yes, right. So this spotted owl, yeah, this spotted owl, this is going to be requiring such a very important thing. Yes, and this barred owl, it can survive anywhere. Yes, so it is so scary and it can survive anywhere. Right. So apart from that, the best examples, it is going to include your tigers, giant pandas, rhinoceros, polar bear, whales, elephant, marine turtles and apes. So all of them are coming under which category? Which category? Your Umbrella species. Yes. Got it? All right. Come on guys. So next we are going to make a move into the next important species, that is called as your dominant species. So what is dominant? Dominant means it is more in number, right? Yes, it is more in number. See, another thing is, this is the major contrast to your dominant and keystone species. In your keystone species, it is disproportionate to the abundance. But remember, in your dominant species, it is going to be proportionate to the abundance. If you have more numbers, the effect will be more. If the number is small, the effect is ultimately going to be small. Right. So the best examples of your dominant species, it includes this alders, right? And then the sea floor, it is containing full of these brittle stars only. Right. So this is another example of your thing. Yes, someone was telling about your Sundarbans. All the mangrove, they uniformly contain certain species. Yes. So they only can survive in this area. Yes, so your mangrove species, right? So these are all the dominant species. They are very rich in abundance. Only they can survive under such condition of your salt. Got it? Right. Next important species, it is going to be your, yes, it is going to be your invasive species. Right. So what do you mean by invasive species? Right. Invasive means problematic. Right. Yes. Certain species which may come from outside. So you, whichever is coming from outside, it is going to be your exotic species. Right. Certain persons are creating trouble. That is the invasive species. But certain species are there that are non-invasive. So they do not make any trouble. So it is called as your non-invasive species. Right. So if it is going to be problematic, then it is called as your invasive species. Yeah. Right. My God. What is this? Your water, I assume. Yes. You can note that many of our lakes, they are fully gone only. Why? Because of this water sand. Yes, Achu. What happens? They block the sunlight. They deplete the DO2. Obviously. Yes. So there is no fish also. Yes, Umarani. Mangroves. Yes. So mangroves, rather than the indicator species, they better come under your dominant species. Why? These mangrove species, they cannot grow everywhere, isn't it? So it is not an indication. Indication is something with reference to the environmental health. Yes. So if you get an option like it is an indicator and a dominant, better you can go with a dominant, isn't it? Because that is more apt than the indicator. All right. Yes. So this water, DO2 dissolved oxygen. Yes. Your dissolved oxygen, it is going to totally go away, right? And if this dissolved oxygen is going, there will won't be any fishes. So the total ecosystem is flopping out. Yes. What is this? Your Congress grass, you call it as a carrot grass also, right? Your Parthenium. My God, it is actually from your North America, but it is occupying all the regions. It grows very fast, yes, and it is of no use. It is making a big trouble, right? Recently they have found that even your Mycobacteria tuberculi, it is very happily cultured with this presence of this Parthenium. All right, next, this Lantana camara. Yes, very beautiful, right? So initially it was grown. Yeah, Pirmal. So this Lantana camara, initially it was grown as an ornamental plant, right? But later they found that it is going to leave some chemicals, and because of this chemical, it is releasing these lalopathic chemicals. Because of this, it is preventing the seed germination. My God, so nobody else can survive. Yes, so this Lantana, it is regarded as a too much problem. Yes. So it is called as your lalopathic. What do you mean by lalopathic? It is going to release the chemical. Because of that chemical, your total germination is avoided. Right. What is this? Yes. What is this? Your Prosopis juliflora. Yes. Right. Oh, yes, Krishna. Yes. In my hometown, this is too much spoiling our this thing. Initially, it was grown for the woods. Yes, right. So now this is overtaking all other plants, right? And this Prosopis juliflora is making the gland to be devastated only, right? So all this is clear. Yes, everywhere it is found. It is found in dry land, grassland, every land this fellow is found. All right. So shall we make a very quick summary? We don't have much time. We will make a very quick summary. We saw what is the keystone species. Yes, so low in abundance, right? But effect is more, right? The second species that we saw was, absolutely Pirmal, the second species that we saw was your dominant species, right? So they are more in number and it is proportionate to the amount that is present, all right? And then indicator species, it tells about the health of your environment, lichens, tubifex worms, all these things. Flagship species, it is like your ambassador, right? Panda, all right. And then what else we saw? Umbrella species, yes, umbrella species, all right. So umbrella species, they have a very need is very high, right? So if that need is met, all other are protected because of that factor. Right, and then we saw about your invasive species. All right, fine. So we will take up one more graph and we will do it up with a couple of questions. All right, so there is a hypothesis called as your rivet popping hypothesis. Right, so this is relative to your biodiversity also. So in the aeroplane, yes, what happens, these nuts and bolts are there. Okay, fine. If one nut is removed, will there be any much effect? If one nut is removed from the aeroplane, yes, do you see any much effect? No. Right, 2 nuts, 3 nuts, 10 nuts, 100 nuts you remove. Yes, 100 screws you remove from the aeroplane. What will happen? What will happen to the aeroplane? It is going to break down. The same thing happens with your rivet popping. Right, if one species is removed, nothing much is going to take place, but you keep on removing that, it is going to make a crash. Right, yes, so that is what it is represented by means of your rivet popping. Right, and what is this keystone hypothesis? Actual graph is this, right? So it will grow from the low to the high. All right, yes. Next one, it is the redundancy. Yeah, redundancy is actually having no much impact. Right, linear, it should go like this, but this is going to be a non-linear one. They can be hump-shaped also. Unpredictable, it is idiosyncratic. All right, fine. So these are all the other species concept that you should remember of. All right, yes, absolutely, absolutely. So the following are the graphical representation of hypothesis that is proposed for explanation between the species richness, right, as well as your community. Okay, right. So what is this graph? Just now we saw this. What is this graph? Yes, everyone. So what is this A? It is going to be none other than your, come on, just now I showed you. What is this A? It is going to be your aeroplane, revert. All right. What is this fellow? He is keeping on increasing and reaching a plateau. Yes. Yes. Yes, J. Come on. Right. Very good. What is this B? B is representing your? Yeah, everyone. Very good. Yes, Achu, Tanushri, Perumal. Very good. So this B is going to represent your redundancy. See here. Yes, yes. So A is your revert, B is your redundancy. Right? What is this C? Unpredictable fellow. Yeah. Very good. Yes, Madhushri, Krishna, Achu. Yes, Dr. Arun. So this is going to be your unpredictable one. It is called as your idiosyncratic. Right. And this, it is a reverse of that fellow, that is going to be your keystone species. So got the point, right? All right. Yes, everyone. Fine. So the next one, which of the following statement is incorrect about your keystone species? Yes, very good, everyone. Which of the following statement is incorrect about your keystone species? Come on, your keystone species. Your species other than your consumers can be a keystone species. Your keystone species, it has an influence on the community which is proportionate to its abundance. Removing a keystone species is reducing your species richness of the community. Removing a keystone species can affect your successive trophic level. So that is going to cause a trophic cascade, which is incorrect. Come on. Yes, Chanda. What about others? Yes. So which is highly incorrect? what we studied about the keystone species versus your dominant species. In dominant species, I told you that it is proportionate to the abundance, right? In keystone species, what did we saw? It is inversely proportionate to the abundance, isn't it? So who is false now? Yeah, this is going to be B. All right, fine. So let us take for instance A, the species other than the consumers, it can be a keystone species. Yes. So we saw many examples. It is not only that your predator alone is going to be a keystone species. Yes. We saw the example of your bees. They are the pollinators. Yes. So many other species are there, isn't it? So it doesn't mean that only your predator or only your consumer, it must be a keystone species. It can happen at any level. Yes, absolutely. But B is absolutely false. It cannot be proportionate to the abundance. It is inversely proportionate to the abundance. Got it? Right. And if you remove the keystone species, that's all. The total species resistance will go, your community will crash. And if you remove the keystone species, it is affecting all the tropic level. So it is creating a cascade effect. Right. Got my point? Very good. Fine. Now this is going to be a very easy question. Yes. Right. So following four types of species were observed in a community. Little bit fast. Come on. Species A, it has the large effect on the community because of its abundance. Right, that is the key word. So your species B has large role in the community out of proportion. That means it is not as per your abundance. Right, C, it is providing the overall health of your ecosystem. And D, it is a recognizable one. Right, yes. So what is going to be the correct answer? Yes, Madhuri. Neelima, Perumal, yes, Kumar, yes, Labdi, Achu, yes, Akhilesh, Arun, yes, Kumar, absolutely, you are all right. So it is none other than your option A, abundance. Yes, yeah, Krishna, Umarani, Mayank, Tanushri. If it is abundance, it is what called as your dominant species. Very good. Yes. And this is dominant species. Out of proportion, it is going to be your keystone. All right. Yes, Aparjita, Sadashivam. Come on. So if it is going to provide your overall health, what it is called as? An indicator species. Good. And if it is going to be a single large one, it is the flagship species. Got it? Right? So absolutely. Yeah, only in A only you are getting the correct answer. All right, very quickly we will take this. See, this is so much times this is getting repeated, isn't it? So this time I expect some mapping with the examples, right? They have asked the definition already. So you should be very careful in learning the example because you might get it. Right, quickly we will do this. Yes, the species with a disproportionality, large effect on the environment relative to its abundance. Yes, what is that? Disproportion. Yes, disproportion means what it is going to be. Yes, disproportion, right? And it is defining a trait or character of an environment. The moment you see the environment, right? And then whose conservation it is leading to the direct protection of species, right? And then which is recognizable and broader conservation. Yes, so the first one should be key, second one should be your indicator, third one is umbrella, and fourth one is flagship. Got my point? All right, everyone. Very good. Keep reading, keep learning. Yes, yeah, Perumal, we are coming up with the English batch. Don't worry. For this next month of July, we are launching with the English batch for all the 13 units also. All right, everyone. So already we do have the full coverage of syllabus. Yes. All right. So now you do have access to the practice MCQ with the detailed solutions. right? And you do have your NTA test series, yeah, Perumal. And we do have your unit-wise week test and mock test, right? We do have your doubt clearance session and live poll, right? And oh yes, everyone, thanks a lot. So 1 year, it is going to be 10,500. You can use my code Saranya Live to get a 10% off, right? And yes, if you are going for a 3 month package, maybe you will get it at a lesser price for the 3 month practice. Yes, this month I am doing with molecular interaction, fundamentals and developmental biology, PYQs. I am doing at 4 p.m. every day, right? But if you take up with a 6 month or 12 month package, definitely. Oh, thanks a lot, Arun. Yes, Chanda, Akilesh, Maya and Kumarani. Yes, Thermal. Right. So you will have all these benefits, right? You will have access to other educators' classes also. So definitely don't miss out these sessions, right? So if you are applying for July, I recommend you 3 months. If you are applying for next December and June, yes, Perumal, you can reach me at my mail biovsa16@gmail.com, right? Yes. So you can mail your queries, your doubts, definitely it will be solved. All right. Yes, everyone. So take care and all the very best. Keep preparing, keep learning. Definitely success is very, very near. All right, everyone. Take care. I'll catch you soon in my next class tomorrow, 4 p.m. Yes. Bye-bye, everyone.